Hey blues fans, this is Anthony from Stevie Snacks, and in this lesson I'm going to talk about some techniques that Jimi Hendrix used for fattening up chords, and consequently Stevie Ray Vaughan used them, and now pretty much any rock guitar player who has learned anything from either of them plays chords this way. So this lesson is not going to be terribly organized. I'm just going to list four or five different things that you can do and the chord shapes that you can do them on. So let's start with the E form bar chord. You're maybe used to seeing it played like this. I tend to play it like this using what I call the grip. When you're holding this chord, one of the things that you can do to sound more like Hendrix is to just do some hammer-ons. Take off your fingers here, do a little hammer-on from the major third, one fret up with your ring finger, and just use a little syncopated picking pattern there. And then you can go back down to its original position. Another thing that you can do with an E-form chord, and Stevie did this in Life Without You sometimes, is to take the bottom note, slide up 1, 2, 3, 4 frets, jump up and hit the octave up from the root with your index finger, slide back down to 2 frets above, and then drop down to the root. Just make sure you're seeing those notes. Another thing you can do with E-form chords is to do a little hammer-on up here. I usually do that with my pinky. He doesn't get a whole lot of love. He just stays down here. So there's just a few tricks you can do with the E-form bar chord. Let's move to a partial G-form chord. One thing you can do right away when you're playing this chord, and it's just these notes here. Instead of just playing it straight, just bar those notes and hammer on the A string. It's like instant Hendrix. But what you got here is you got all these little combinations of hammer-ons that you can do. But it's all contingent on you keeping these strings barred. G string, D string, A string. Now on these two, you always want to pull off, but you never want to pull off. You don't want to pull off on this one because that's what forms the chord. Another little trick you can do with these is when you're sliding from the 4 to the 5 chord. Whenever you're sliding from the 4 to the 5, using these partial G-form chords, you can just go and just hammer on, even on this halfway step. Now, another trick that you can do with these, and this one is a little bit more related to music theory, so, you know, if this sounds like Greek to you, then you can just feel free to ignore it. But when you are playing, let's say, in the key of A flat, so our one chord and our root fret down here is at the 5th fret. When we are playing a 5 chord with using a partial G form here, we can switch between the 5 chord and the 1 chord by playing a D form, which happens to be right above the partial G form here. So let's take, for example, this chord progression. So what happened there? Well, when I got to the 5, I jumped up to the 1 chord in D form here, right above the, And I can just do that because of its proximity to the five chord here. So it's kind of like a prelude to me circling back around to the one chord. Now, one thing that I threw in there that you might not have caught was I threw in a two chord. And anytime you are playing an E form chord minor, you can do a lot of the same tricks that you can do with a partial G form chord. We can do, and because we're sticking to the D, it sounds a little bit like, but what differentiates them is where it started. That kind of anchors those hammer-ons to this chord. Now, the last kind of chord trick that I want to talk about is related to the one where I talked about jumping from the five temporarily up to the one chord. Let's use that same principle, but on a different set of chords. So if this is our one chord, if we play the partial G form of that same chord, three frets down, if we do that when we're playing the one chord as a partial G form, we get, follow that chord down, find its root right there. It's a four chord. So the reason I bring this up is because one of Hendrix's more popular songs starts out, and I'm not going to obviously teach much of that for copyright reasons, but it sounds so complicated, but all it's doing, in that case, it would be an E flat, so our one chord would be right here. It starts off with hammer-ons. If you would form the four chord here, with the root being right there, and then just hammer these two fingers on and off. That's all that's happening, is he's starting from the four, going to the one, and then hitting the root of the one down at the bottom. So that's just another one of those tricks that deals with the relationship of the chord forms to each other. D form right above a G form here. If this is a one chord, then this is a four. If this is the five chord, then this is the one. So that deals with where the root notes of the different chords are on the fretboard, but anyway, I kind of feel like this lesson is a big jumbled mess of tips and tricks, which is kind of how I hate to do it, but I felt that it would be nice to put out a lesson just teaching different ways of augmenting these chords to make them sound nice and fat, like Stevie Ray Vaughan and Jimi Hendrix. So anyway, I hope you're able to make some sense of that, and that it was fun for you to watch. Thanks for watching.